The first species of hominins that can be considered one of our own, with only slight differences, and worthy of the name human, is a species called Homo ergaster, or working man. Homo ergaster appeared in Africa around 2.2 million years ago, and, unlike earlier hominins, bore the greatest resemblance to modern humans. This species was the first hominin capable of living in various environmental conditions, ranging from humid regions to dry climates, far from the shelter of dense forests, in open savanna plains with extremely hot weather. This hominin walked exclusively on two legs and had a tall stature with a lean, elongated body. They not only managed to migrate out of Africa, but also reached Europe and distant lands such as Southeast Asia. They traversed the mid-latitudes of Eurasia, contributing to the extinction of various ape species in Asia that had lived there before. This first migration out of Africa led to a wide range of diversity among the descendants of this human species. It might not be an exaggeration to say that Homo ergaster is the ancestor of all humans that followed. Homo ergaster can be considered the origin of many subsequent developments in human evolution, such as the use of fire, hunting, more complex social organization, Acheulean technology, and more. Around 2 million years ago, Homo ergaster likely succeeded in migrating out of Africa and quickly dispersed throughout Asia. Interestingly, the first fossilized remains of this human species were not discovered in Africa, but rather in Southeast Asia in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. At that time, since no other hominin species had been identified that showed evidence of bipedalism, scientists named this species Homo erectus, or upright man. The oldest fossil remains in Southeast Asia are dated between 1.8 million and 1.7 million years ago. However, in later years, as more archaeological excavations were conducted, older fossils of this species were found in Africa. Bernard Wood, a renowned American paleoanthropologist, suggested that the Asian specimens should continue to be referred to as Homo erectus, or specifically Asian Homo erectus, while the African specimens should be called African Homo erectus or Homo ergaster. Although the African and Asian fossils clearly diverged from a common ancestral population, they show morphological differences. This divergence is unsurprising, given their separate evolutionary paths in vastly different environments over several hundred thousand years. The cranial capacity of this species in adults averaged between 900 and 1,200 cubic centimeters. In the early stages of its existence, Homo ergaster did not behave much differently from its ancestors. Although this human species had clearly modern anatomical features, it was not initially distinguished by its tool-making technology. Like its predecessors, who had continued making simple tools for nearly a couple of million years, Homo ergaster still relied on basic tools. For several hundred thousand years after its first appearance, it continued to use flaked pebbles and sharp-edged stone flakes, which are characteristic of the Oldowan tool industry. As mentioned earlier, Homo ergaster lived in Africa around 2.2 million years ago. However, it was only around 1.7 million years ago that newer types of stone tool technologies, such as the Acheulean hand axe, emerged and became widespread. This innovation first appeared in Africa and gradually spread beyond the continent. It is important to note that every new technology among hominins has its roots in earlier species and did not appear suddenly. However, it seems that Homo ergaster possessed cognitive abilities superior to its ancestors. These mental capacities enabled it to better understand and perceive its surroundings, which manifested through the discovery of more suitable technologies. Earlier toolmakers produced simple flakes with sharp cutting edges. They were indifferent to the shape of the flakes they created, as their only concern was that the tool could cut. After some time, though, Homo ergaster moved beyond the old, simple stone tools and began producing more complex and larger implements known as Acheulean hand axes. These hand axes, due to their versatility and various tasks, earned the nickname Swiss Army Knives of the Paleolithic. The Acheulean hand axes and their variations were tools with sharp, narrow points or cleavers with straight edges. After the emergence of Acheulean technology by Homo ergaster, the production of Oldowan tools did not cease. In fact, the toolmaking repertoire became more complete over time. The advent of new technologies did not immediately render older technologies obsolete. Rather, new technologies continued to build upon the old ones. Over time, they were gradually replaced as the needs of human societies evolved. For instance, even today, with the rise of new technologies like smartphones, landline phones are still in use, though they may eventually be phased out entirely in the future. This process mirrors how technological advancements in earlier human history unfolded. New innovations coexisted with older ones for extended periods before becoming dominant. Around 1.7 million years ago, when this new technology emerged, Acheulean hand axes were produced in vast quantities, sometimes even beyond practical need. There are archaeological sites in Africa and Southeast Asia where large numbers of these hand axes are found scattered across the ground, leading to these locations being referred to as hand axe caches. Interestingly, many of these hand axes are so large that they are essentially unusable. Some scholars suggest that these oversized hand axes were created by individuals who wanted to display their skill in stone toolmaking. Others go further, proposing that this behavior, creating non-functional tools, was a form of male display in front of females. The idea is that the maker aimed to demonstrate their ability to produce high-quality tools, which would imply prowess in hunting, scavenging, and providing food for the group, especially to attract the opposite sex. Cognitive scientists also note that this behavior could reflect a form of perfectionism in these early humans, indicating a deeper psychological drive behind their tool-making practices. In summary, Homo ergaster, or Homo erectus, was a species that, in terms of body structure, especially from the neck down, was very similar to modern humans. Due to their adaptation to tropical climates, and based on skeletal fossils discovered, scientists have concluded that Homo ergaster had a tall, lean, and elongated body. Additionally, like many people living in present-day Africa, they had lost their body hair. There is little doubt that the common ancestors of hominins and apes were covered in thick body hair. However, it is certain that hominins gradually lost this dense body hair through evolution. The loss of body hair in the human lineage, along with the ability to sweat and thus cool the body through the skin, allowed humans to survive long walks in the hot African climate without overheating. Sweating was a crucial adaptation for living in the warm regions of East and Southeast Africa. While we still don't know exactly how much body hair early bipeds had, it's likely that since they spent much of their lives in shaded areas, they retained some of their body hair. In contrast, Homo erectus, or Homo ergaster, likely had bare, hairless skin. Due to the abundance of the dark pigment melanin, which is characteristic of tropical regions and protects against harmful UV rays, they likely had dark skin to shield themselves from the sun. Sweating enabled Homo ergaster to walk extremely long distances and track animals for hunting over the course of several days. Based on ethnographic studies conducted in Africa, it has been determined that Homo ergaster likely used a hunting method similar to what some modern African tribes practice today, known as persistence hunting. In this technique, hunters would initially approach four-legged animals and then steadily and consistently follow their tracks at a regular pace. When the animals encountered the hunters, they would sprint away, but after covering a certain distance, they were forced to stop to cool down, as their bodies were covered in hair or fur, preventing them from dissipating heat efficiently through their skin. Unlike humans, who could sweat and keep cool, these animals were unable to release body heat effectively, causing them to stop frequently. This gave the hunters the advantage of eventually catching up with their prey, as the animals would become overheated and exhausted. At this time, when Homo ergaster approached the prey, the animal would flee again, and this chase could continue for hours until the animal eventually stopped moving. The prolonged exertion and elevated body temperature could even lead to the animal's internal organs being cooked. Only then could Homo ergaster catch and kill the animal. Because of this demanding lifestyle in Africa, archaeologists chose the name working man for this species. Additionally, these physical characteristics led to Homo ergaster being described as walking machines, given their remarkable ability to travel long distances in pursuit of prey. Their endurance and efficiency in covering large distances for hunting were key aspects of their survival strategy. These humans lived in groups with simple social relationships, though more complex than their ancestors. They inhabited both caves and open-air sites. Archaeologists have found evidence in some ancient sites of these humans building very primitive shelters. Their lifestyle was mainly based on gathering natural resources, scavenging, and hunting. As mentioned in previous videos, Homo ergaster was the first human to master fire around 1.5 million years ago. The use of fire helped them cook the meat of animals and some plants, as well as keep predators at bay. Mastering fire, as one of the pivotal moments in human evolution, gave this species new abilities for survival and advancement. One of the most important characteristics shared by all humans on Earth, distinguishing them from other animals, is the ability to analyze and draw conclusions based on evidence. Humans possess a symbolic mind, meaning they can infer the origin of something by observing a symbol. For instance, when humans see animal tracks on the ground, they can immediately visualize the creature that left those marks. This ability to recognize symbols and link them to the underlying reality is a critical feature that emerged in human ancestors and played a vital role in hunting and tracking animals. It might seem that other animals, like dogs, leopards, or wolves, also exhibit similar abilities, often even better than humans. However, the difference lies in the fact that these animals primarily track their prey through their strong sense of smell, not by observing and analyzing visual evidence. The human ability to interpret symbols and draw conclusions from them, processing visual information and turning it into practical knowledge, is one of the skills that set humans apart in the course of evolution. Scientists believe that Homo erectus, or Homo ergaster, was the first human species to possess a complex ability to analyze and draw conclusions from evidence. One prevailing hypothesis is that the early migration of Homo ergaster out of Africa may have been due to tracking herds of animals that, in response to the drying of East African grasslands, were forced to leave the region. Environmental changes and population pressure could have been key factors in the initial dispersal of this species. It is likely that African Homo erectus left the continent around 2 million years ago, before the invention of Acheulean technology and the mastery of fire. However, it is important to note that the migration out of Africa was not a one-way journey, and descendants of the humans who first left may have eventually returned to Africa. When hominins freed themselves from the confines of forest margins, they were able to roam and wander much more freely than before. The humans who left Africa heading east settled in the semi-tropical regions of East Asia. Meanwhile, those groups that migrated north and northeast faced the harsh environment of Europe at that time. Due to the long mountain ranges and hostile climatic conditions, they were unable to advance further into Europe. This explains why fossils of this species dating back as far as 1.8 million years have been found in tropical and semi-tropical regions of Asia, and even the Caucasus, while no fossil evidence older than 800,000 years has been discovered in Central and Western Europe. The migrations of humans from Africa were not intentional efforts to explore distant parts of the world. The tendency to spread and expand occurred more gradually at the edges of populations. If a population moves an average of 2 or 3 kilometers per year over geological timescales, an entire continent can gradually become inhabited within a relatively short period. Archaeological evidence from the period between 1.8 million and 700,000 years ago in Asia indicates at least 3 waves of early human migrations. These waves have been identified through evidence of tools and stone technologies. The first wave of Oldowan toolmakers around 2 to 1.8 million years ago. The second wave of early Acheulean toolmakers around 1.7 million years ago. The third wave of migration around 800,000 years ago, characterized by Acheulean stone industries, including cleavers and large flake tools. Homo erectus is recognized as a successful species with the longest duration among hominins. The oldest evidence of this species dates back to around 2.2 million years ago in Africa, while the most recent records of some of its descendants in the Indonesian islands extend to about 110,000 years ago. In the next video, we will explore the story of the first fossil discovery of this human and several other astonishing findings related to them. Stay with me.